Better hurry.
Okay, it's safe now.
I got a really bad feeling about all of this.
I'm gonna need those keys to the diner now. There's a motel key there that I have to get.
Oh, hey, you don't have to do that. I have the motel master key. I work for the same company, you know. What's at the motel?
Well, there's a dead guy. He's got something I need to get into the Mount Redtooth Observatory.
God, that's awful. Hey, you wanted to know about the guy who looked like you, didn't you?
The last time you said he had a party, but you didn't go.
No, that's not true. I did go. It was really great at first, and then I didn't see it myself, but I hear he turned nasty. He hurt a bunch of guys pretty bad, and there was this girl, she died. But I didn't hear about that until afterwards. I thought that he was so charming.
And then he went to the diner.
That's right. I wasn't involved. I wasn't involved with that at all. I don't know what happened.
Fine. I need to check out these motel rooms. In the meantime, you stay here, okay? I'm serious. Keep the lights on and stay here.
Yeah, okay. You got it. I sure hope you're right about this.
It's said that nobody knows what the future might bring, but for this man, it's no longer entirely true. A weaker man might simply give up, but the Champion of Light is an expert on destiny. Sometimes the puppet and puppeteer can be one and the same. Redtooth, its top littered with man-made eyes that stare into the endless depths of space. Tonight, the Champion of Light will depend on them to pick out a message from the ether. As history repeats itself, the man remembers the patterns. He knows that he needs the missing part for the telescope.
That's where the camera should be.
Oh, praise be. You guys are coming through for me. A pretty little light just started blinking on my board here, and that means there's a
forgive me, but this feels very strange. It seems like this has all happened before.
I have the replacement part for your telescope, Doctor.
All right. Let's get it installed.
Yet. There's a problem with the cooling system.
Yes, that's right. I remember. Alright, let me think. If they're sabotaging it, they'll be at the primary coolant pipe outside. If you can secure it, we should be ready to pick up the signal. That is why you're here, isn't it?
Yes, it is. I'll take care of it.
Before you go, if you have the time, I'd appreciate if you came up here and explained a few things. All of this is very strange to me.
Am I correct? You should be able to turn on the light to view the area that way.
I think we're good to go.
All right. I'll start looking for the signal. Please, head back.
They didn't like that. Thank you. find the signal?
Yes. I don't think it's quite the same thing we had, the last time. Still, we're definitely picking it up.
Are we getting the complete signal now?
I'm afraid not. Take a look at it yourself. I'm printing out a hard copy now. I'd like to ask you a question or two before that, though, if you don't mind.
Another printout. Another signal fragment. The message is still not complete, but it's another piece of the weapon he has built against his adversary. Mere words on a piece of paper, but in the right hands, they will hold back the darkness. The last time the man came to the drive-in, it did not end well. He hopes to avoid that fate this time. He hopes that what he has brought with him to this place is enough.
Ugh. Serena's probably out of her mind again. But I'm gonna need that key so I can get the power back on.
You again?
I'm really just here to get the key so I can get the power back on.
You wanna hold me down? It's okay. I know you like that.
Yeah, I'll just grab the keys.
I could be like your wife. Little wifey. Waiting at home for hubby. Or you could be the mailman. Or the neighbor.
I'm already married to someone who isn't crazy, thanks. I'm just gonna go and get the power back on. Look, I may or may not be back. I have the access code to the booth already, so once the power is on...
You should totally come see me. We could have fun. You know.
We'll see how it goes.
I was about to do the weather, but I see we have a caller. Hey, you're on the air with Eddie. What's up?
Hey, Eddie, it's Ricky. You talked about fate before. You think about that a lot?
Not a lot, to be honest, but I take it you do.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Any conclusions you'd care to share, Ricky?
Are you getting it yet, genius?
little hamster in a wheel. Go ahead and keep running for all the good it'll give. Die, you lose. If you quit, you lose. If you make it to the end of the loop, you still lose. Sucker.
The Champion of Light knows that the time itself is about to end. At least for him. He can feel the dead end rushing towards him. But there is time to act. Incomplete or not, he has the weapon.
I don't have the whole thing, but maybe it's enough.
Cute, aren't you? What are you up to? It's a waste of time, buddy. You should just lie down and die. Let me take over. This is the only thing you've got coming to you. From here to eternity.
No matter how many times you come back.
Time folds back on itself. Again, his senses scream as the very impossibility of what is happening assaults them. But the Champion of Light endures. Each time he gets a little closer, each time another detail falls into place. Now, the trap works against the Herald of Darkness. Right on cue, bubbling to the surface from untold depths, the horrors. The emerging monsters do not expect the warm reception that has already been prepared for them.
Thank you.
saving Emma.
Yeah, thanks for saving me again. I'd hate to die before I'm scheduled to be murdered.
I guess I have you to thank for setting everything up at the oil derrick.
Yeah, well, I figured that if we were going to go over this again, we might as well try to be smart about it, huh?
I appreciate it. You took a big chance doing that. Are you okay?
What do you think? I've died twice. I remember everything pretty clearly now. You said I was gonna be okay.
I don't know what happened.
It's not your fault. I think one of those, what did you call them? The takers? I think they did something to the power and they got me that way.
I'm sorry.
But I got the keys from the dead guy in that room. And I'm not handing them over until you do something about this. I'm sick of getting killed.
Fair enough. You seem calmer now.
I tried freaking out. Didn't do much good for me. I guess you get used to the craziest stuff.
Good for you.
Plus, I figured I'd take the edge off, you know?
Mm-hmm. Those herbal supplements are pretty good, huh? Okay. I really don't think they can get to the power now.
Thank you. That's a relief. Here's the keys that you needed.
Thank you.
Hey, I have to tell you. At the diner, I went there with him. The guy who looks like you, okay? I know I said that I didn't.
Yeah, I figured.
Thank you.
fate of countless individuals hangs in the balance, threatened by the machinations of the Herald of Darkness. And yet, for a moment, the Champion of Light breathes a little easier. He has saved one life. For this moment, it is enough. And soon, perhaps, he can put an end to this. Returning to the observatory for what he hopes is the final time, the man feels anticipation and dread in equal measure. Soon, he knows, he will have what he needs.
Hello, I was expecting you. I've already taken care of the imaging array, but you should still look into securing the primary code. Some of us may be able to light the area before the things show up. I believe we're ready to look into the sky.
Right there, Doctor!
Thank you.
wish these things would stop blatantly violating the laws of physics in my observatory. That's just rude. Are you all right?
I'll live.
I'm glad. I'll send the lift down to you. I remember our previous encounters very clearly now. But technically, if this really is a loop in time, we've never met before. I don't know why our awareness persists, but it's bloody fascinating.
You know, I know physicists who would give 15 years of their lives for a chance to experience something like this.
I'd imagine that being stalked by horrible axe murderers would curb their enthusiasm a little.
Clearly you've never met hardcore physicists.
I'm glad you're in such good spirits, but...
The signal! Yes, it's completed!
Finally.
In a strange way, he feels at ease. He is armed with his own words, and when the time comes, they will be enough, or they will not. For now, he's content to let the currents take him toward the final confrontation. Once more, we return to the drive-in. If he's aware of the absurdity of arming oneself with a few sentences and standing against a power that can pierce time itself, he doesn't show it. The man has his share of weaknesses, perhaps more, but cowardice is not among them.
Oh, you got yourself a little plan, do you?
never getting out of this, Wake. Never! Don't worry. I'll take care of your wife and your life.
I'll send you right back to the beginning.
Whatever it is you're gonna do is gonna make a difference? This'll end up just like before!
Thank you.
Again, the Champion of Light enters the final trap. The new reality is almost here. All he needs to do is change the details of the scene, push it past the breaking point, and the rest will snap into place.
Come on, buddy. Why don't you... What? What is this?
Is it really you?
It's really me.
How? I love you.
I love you.
Dawn. They both feel it. He's home at last. Are these actual events, or merely a dream? A memory, or a glimpse of what is to come? One thing is certain. This scene takes place in another time, and another place, far, far away. From Night Springs.